Now tell me, my dear brothers, have you ever taken Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam as Allah or the Rasul of Allah? I want the answer from you. Rasul of Allah or Allah? Rasul of Allah. Have you ever taken Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu as Allah or the Khalifa of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Answer please. Again, have you ever taken Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu as Allah or a great Imam of the Ummah? Have you ever taken Sayyidina Ghawthul Azam radiallahu anhu as Allah or a friend of Allah? We never said nor we ever believe that Rasul Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Allah. No, he is a creation of Allah and the best of the creation. Ghawthul Azam radiallahu anhu is not Allah. He is the wali of Allah and the leader of all the awliya Allah. Khaja Mu'inuddin is not Allah, but he is also a leader of awliya Allah. When we go for this ziyarah of this awliya, do we go to these people taking them as Allah or the friends of Allah? We take them as friends of Allah. And Alhamdulillah, we never go to the grave of Fir'aun. We never go to the grave of Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Utba or Shayba. We go to the graves of the pious servants of Allah just for the reason they are accepted in the holy court of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We never worship these awliya, but we do respect these friends of Allah. And visiting the graveyard, visiting a pious servant of Allah, this is a clear indication that we are away from shirk. We are away from shirk. This is a clear indication. Let me explain you in my simple language. For example, we are here at the holy court of Sayyidina Shaykh Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. That means Sayyidina Shaykh Uthman radiallahu anhu is resting in his grave. And for him to rest in his grave, he has to taste the death. Without tasting the death, you won't be buried. And to taste the death, he has to be living in this world for a particular time. And to live in the world, he has to be born. Without birth, none can live. Without living, no death. Without death, no grave. Subhanallah. My dear brothers, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has stated in the Holy Quran, Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Allah doesn't possess any children, nor Allah was given birth. And these awliya were born. Is there any way to associate Allah, these awliya, with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala? Allah is not born from ever, forever, azali, abadi, qadim. Allah is from ever, forever. Subhanallah. And these awliya Allah, they are not eternal as Allah. They are not from ever, but they are creation of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and they had birth in this world. So there is no way to call any association for the people to call as shirk. Again, Allah has stated in the Holy Quran, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. Allah is the one who created everything of this world for your sake. Everything is being created for us. Does Allah need to live in this world? Allah is the one who created the world. Does Allah need to live in this world? The whole earth has no value in the sight of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah created this world for us to live, and everything of this world for us to get benefits. Subhanallah. So again, no way of association. They lived in this world. For Allah, there is no need to live in this world. Allah has stated in the Holy Quran, in Ayatul Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum, la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm. For Allah, there is no sleep nor drowsiness. No sleep nor drowsy. Allahu Akbar. And these pious servants of Allah did taste the death. See the huge difference. Where is death and where is the drowsiness? Allah doesn't have even sleep or drowsiness. And these pious servants of Allah, they did taste death. Allah doesn't possess a grave. These people are resting inside the grave. When there is no way of association, still if people call us as mushrik, aren't they accusing we Muslims? Allahu Akbar. My dear brothers, visiting the pious servants of Allah, this is a clear indication that we have not taken them as Allah, but servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Pious servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, because we believe they were given birth, they lived in this world, they did taste it, and they are resting inside the grave. Again, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, the grave is either a garden from the gardens of Jannah or a place from the place of the hellfire. For the believer, it is a garden of Jannah, and for an unbeliever, it is a part of the hill. My dear brothers, by visiting the grave of the pious servants of Allah, in light of the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are besides a place which is a garden from Jannah, and Allah is not in need to live in Jannah. Allah has created Jannah for the believers. So alhamdulillah, by visiting a pious servant of Allah, we are clearly indicating this matter, that we never take them as Allah, not worthy of worship, but Allah is alone worthy of worship. And these pious servants of Allah are true servants of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They are the creation of Allah. Even after this, if a person by quoting these verses which are related to the idols and idol worshippers, if they accuse us saying you are a mushrik, your father was a mushrik, by calling Ya Ghawthal Adam, by proclaiming Ya Rasulallah, he has accused not only we few people, but all the people from the time of Sahaba until now. Because Sahaba Kiram Ridwanullahi Alayhim Ajmain, they did proclaim Ya Rasulallah. Refer to the history of Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anh. They did proclaim Ya Muhammada. Refer to Imam Bukhari's Al-Adabul Mufrad, that Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu did proclaim Ya Muhammada, Ya Rasulallah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. These words were proclaimed by Sahaba Kiram. So according to these people, were the Sahaba also mushrik? Were the Tabi'in also mushrik? Sayyiduna Imam Abu